This video is going to be about solving equations with multiplication or division. So here's what we're talking about. Let's say you've got a problem like 2x equals 8. We want to find out what the x is. So that means we have to isolate the x. We have to get it by itself. Well, since the x was multiplied by 2, we can get rid of that 2 by dividing by 2. In other words, division undoes multiplication. If we divide one side of an equation by a number, we have to divide the other side by the same number. So carrying out the division, 2 divided by 2 is just going to give me 1. So I can cross those out and just write x. I don't have to write a 1 in front of the x. And 8 divided by 2 is going to give me a 4. So that should be my answer. Let's check and see if it works. So I had 2x equals 8. That was my original problem. If x equals 4, I can replace the 4 where I've got the x. So 2 times 4 equals 8, and 2 times 4 does equal 8. So this problem checks. The answer is x equals 4. Let's look at this one. Let's say I've got x divided by 3 equals negative 5. And once again, I want to isolate that x. I want to get it by itself. So since I had the x being divided, the way to undo division would be to multiply. So I'm going to multiply this fraction, x over 3, by 3. If I multiply one side of an equation by a number, I've got to multiply the other side by the same number. So that means I have to multiply the right side of the equation by 3. Doing the multiplication on the left, these 3's are going to cancel, which is what I wanted to happen. That's what I expected. So I'll cross those out, and now I've just got an x. Doing the multiplication on the right side, I've got negative 5 times 3 is going to give me negative 15. And I can check this. So my original equation was x over 3 equals negative 5. If I think my answer is x equals negative 15, I want to put that negative 15 where the x is. So negative 15 divided by 3 equals negative 5. And negative 15 divided by 3 does equal negative 5. So this answer works. Now, it doesn't matter whether we get the x isolated on the left side of an equation or the right side of an equation. So for instance, if I was given the problem 7 equals 3x, my goal is to get that x by itself. I can do that by dividing by 3. So I'm going to divide the right side of the equation by 3, which means I want to divide the left side of the equation by 3. The right side is just going to give me an x. These 3's will cancel. The left side, 7 over 3, doesn't reduce. So I'm going to leave it as 7 over 3 equals x. And if I want to, I can rewrite that as x equals 7 over 3. To check my answer, I'm going to go back, write the original problem again. 7 equals 3x. Instead of the x, I'll put in what I believe my answer to be, 7 over 3. So 7 equals 3 times 7 over 3. Checking this, I can cancel out these two 3's. I get 7 equals 7. So my answer is correct. That's all there is to it. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.